Hey, here we go.
Haven't done these in a while. What up, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of In Too Deep. I'm your host, Alan Best. Thank God that phone rang, just because... Yeah, this is not the podcast. This is the vlog. This is a vlog. What up, everybody, and welcome back to the vlogs. Haven't done a vlog in a while, as you guys can tell. I'm so hooked up on the podcast that that's all I've been doing. So thank you guys for tuning in, subscribing, liking, doing everything you guys can possibly do to interact with me and the podcast and the Instagram. I appreciate you guys for watching the podcast and, you know, sending me clips and stuff. That's beyond amazing. You guys are awesome. Didn't think that it will grow to be like where it is now, and the sponsorships and the people, just the people in general, like, you guys are very amazing. Just takes me back to, like, you know, soccer days where, like, the fans were just, like, going crazy over, like, you know. So it's something super cool for this movement. So yeah, today I'm gonna be talking about the new logo and just like a little updates on things that are going that's gonna go down. like, okay, example, vlogs are coming back. I'm gonna be doing those music videos. I have a couple projects coming out soon, recording wise, and you know, music video type vibe. The last one was the golfing one, so I might be doing another golfing one soon. So let's just get with it. Today we have We're just going to be doing from what the logo started from the beginning of Lost Boys. I don't think I ever, like, clarified on how it started, and have this story that it really should inspire a lot of you and, like, should not discourage anyone from doing anything in life. Just get that clear. This is something that I take a lot of pride in, because from where it started to where it is now, it's beyond amazing and incredible, just for me, like a personal achievement from where I've wanted it. In 2017, when I created this logo logo was absolutely not like this, but the brand was just like a movement for me to, you know, inspire people to keep people persevering and getting through, like, the toughest times by themselves and, like, push through. But I realized over the years, again, 2020 was the rough year for everyone, I believe, and coming out with this podcast really inspired a lot of people to come on, a lot of people to do these things and, you know, push through. And I got a lot of comments. My favorite one was, I'm not going to name anyone. Favorite one was this person. He texted me. I kept posting things, like, just inspirational, keep it up. Like, and this person texted me saying, like, hey, bro, I had a lot of things that were going in my life, forms of depression, suicidal thoughts, and my post, he said that I just kept looking forward to every day that when you're posting these motivational things, that, you know, it just kept me going and kept me doing whatever I need to do. And that honestly is, like, the grasping, the most, that's what keeps me going, is your guys's energy to keep pushing me to make content or keep pushing me to do more towards this community. And again, every purchase, even if I, you know, post about it or not, every purchase goes directly to NAMI. A percentage goes to NAMI, the National Alliance of Mental Health, Mental Illness. Yeah, it's super, super important that you guys, you know, reach out to your friends. Make sure your friends are okay. Make sure your family is okay. Just reach out to them. Do anything, whatever you can possibly do, just be there for your family, be there for your friends. You don't know the battles that anyone's going through, so don't judge anybody. Don't look at somebody at a certain way, because you don't know, you know? So, yeah. little PSA there. That being said, let's just get to it. The logo. The first logo. The Times New Roman 12-point font. MLA format, double space. Everything you learn in high school and college. That logo was the very first one. January 7th is when I dropped it. I can tell you the story behind that. I'll tell you afterwards when I get to the story. So this one, the butterfly, was signifies never lose hope. If you guys have read the book Papillon or Papillon, I don't know how to pronounce it properly, because in Spanish, it's double L, you know. And but it's in French. It's not a French book, but like it's the title's in French and it means butterfly. After reading that book like a couple times, the message I got from it was never lose hope. And it's a blue butterfly on the cover. And so I tied that on to mental health, tied that on to people belonging to something. The feeling of never being alone is the big message of, you know, depression. And like, you guys are not alone. Trust me, you guys are not alone. You can DM me, you can text me, whatever contact, a form of contact you have of mine, do so. Like, just text me, call me. I prefer calls because, I don't know, texting all the time. I'm a dry texter. You guys already, whoever knows me, I'm pretty dry. So, therefore, yeah, the message behind this one was towards mental health. It was towards people who just feel like they couldn't. Lost Boys, you guys know the grim stories, like of Peter Pan being an angel, like conspiracies, I could say, conspiracies of like Peter Pan being an angel and like, you know, recruiting, like guiding these lost boys, the basically dead kids, to heaven, Neverland. And that's where I kind of like, you know, based it off of. Is like, I'm not saying I'm Peter Pan, but I'm saying I'm a person that would like to guide a whole movement of people to come together and be together as one. Moving on to the next drop, and also to the butterfly, it's Penelope, my daughter. When she was born, we always had like butterflies all over the place for her, and it's something that really like grasped it on. So this movement was inspired for her. Like, she's the one who kept me grounded and never, like, the person who I honestly built this whole thing for, just because she was like my muse. She was the one who pushed me to be better, and from where I was, it was just like a whole of nonsense that I don't want to touch up on, because I might even say it on a podcast one day. Yeah, huge shout out to P. If you ever listen to this and you ever, you know, she's about to be two, so she won't really understand, but she will one day, and I hope she does. So going on to the new logo, the Lost Boys, graffiti looking Lost Boys. It's called The Tale of Two Cities, LA, San Diego. The reason why is because, well, I'm from San Diego. Okay, so when you travel to these cities, you always try to focus on the skyline, the beauty of the, you know, skyscrapers and like all these nice buildings, but not a lot of people pay attention to the rural areas, the, you know, where the homeless live, where all these people like are trashed and like it's like the ugly, the ghetto parts. But there's always beauty in art, and looking at those like special spots, you never appreciate it as much. And like for me, I remember going to San Diego one time, going under a bridge, and there was this guy spray painting away, and leaving this whole mural, like a beautiful mural of, like, I don't know, I forgot what it was. It was during the BLM times. When all that stuff happened. Don't want to get into it because I don't want to, you know, touch something sensitive. It was during like the movement, and they were just spray painting away, and it was like parts where nobody will see it, which was sad, but it's something that really like stood out to me, because when I drive to, you know, those places, I go to like to Coronado, the nice, you know, bay of San Diego, but I love seeing that art. So putting together this, the graffiti looking Lost Boys, was this, what people don't see is the people who want to belong to society in their own way, but they get, you know, they get said like, oh, they're homeless, like we don't want them here, they get kicked out. So this is something that it's like pushing for those people. It's the new charity. I need to find one, but it is it will go to them, like the homeless shelters and people like that, because it's something that, you know, I took note on, and I want to push the message out for them. This is really cool. You guys, if like, again, a percentage goes to a charity once you buy one. I see you wearing one, you definitely will. I will follow you, and I will take video with you and or picture. I'll do anything. Don't want to name names again, but I don't even know who they were, but Shout out to the person who caught me at 7-Eleven and said, you're the Lost Boys dude, and then drove away saying, I love your videos. You're awesome. I don't know who you were, but if you watch my videos, like you said, you do. Yeah, thanks for finding me. That was like the first, that was the second time I got noticed in like public. And yeah, shout out to Fabric. Again, I've said that in the last podcast or two podcasts ago. Yeah. So let me get to the $10 story. This is the first Lost Boys merch. Beginning of the year, it was kind of rough for me. I'd say it was like right after the podcast season one ended. I was like, I have nothing else to do. Maybe I can do this. And everything was just failing. And I was just like, crap. There was one day I just had $10 in my pocket. I was like, fuck, what am I going to do? What else can I do? It was like, I'm going to stay home. Let's rest up, you know, turn the TV on, whatever. But I didn't like that. I don't like that idea. I don't like that mentality. So I had $10 and I finished talking to my friend. He told me that he had a friend who does shirts. Jaime, shout out to you, dude. Thank you for legitimately hooking it up. And I had a gray plain hoodie. and I just like was motivated to just, you know, I was like, hey, maybe I can make this one a hoodie, make my merch already. And I sent him the, the 12 point font, the Times New Roman. And he made it a shirt. I gave him a thing. I had 10 bucks. He told me it was $8. I was like, all right, cool. 10 bucks. Sorry. Cool. Handed him the 10 bucks and he started this. Next thing you know, I took a picture, a mere selfie. Don't judge me. I took a mere selfie and sent it to all my friend groups. And I think this is a story where everybody should just take in as motivation. Take this as, don't ever be discouraged. Just always try to make something out of what you have. And I'm beyond grateful for the push that my family has been over the last couple months with the podcast, how supportive they've been every week doing the show here. They're very supportive. They're very loving. They're very caring. My mom being a fan of the show, my sisters being behind the camera, they're excellent. I mean, we're all learning together how to be better. And just don't ever be discouraged on what like you have. Just always push through with whatever it is. And I know one day that everybody will be on the same boat and everybody will be winning. Again, I have this saying, it's if once I rise, we all rise. And I will not let anybody behind. I will always try to get and push out the more content as much as possible. Again, if you guys want to be a part of this Lost Boys movement, go ahead. You can buy, DM me for, I don't have a website yet, but soon, hopefully soon, you guys can, you know, order just from the website and I can, you know, move on with the purchases and shipping and all that stuff. So another thing, if you want to be part of the Lost Boys membership, that's, through contracts. I'm finalizing contracts just to go like looking over and, how it looks. And so far they're looking great. They're looking good. They're ready for some people that I have on the low. I'm very excited to be working with these guys. Again, it's open to everyone, but there's always like a expectation, which is content. If you guys like, you guys have to push out content every week. If you guys want to be part of that, DM me and like let me know and we can make like a whole, it's going to be like a whole content team. So thank you guys for listening, watching. This is not going to be on Spotify. I have the mentality of Into Deep. Check out Into Deep. Check out the vlogs. Link in the description for everything you guys need to know about me. My Instagram, my personal, my co-host. Everything's on there. Please check us out. Yeah, I got nothing else to say. Check out on Sunday. We'll be out for a new podcast. It's going to be an exciting one. Car enthusiast, YouTuber. His link's going to be in the description as well. Very excited to be posting this. Check it out. See you guys. Peace. I think I made it. I think I made it, cause I'm always smiling and you're the reason now. Girl, I can't explain it. It's all in the timing. I had to get low. I had to get low. I had to get back. Oh, shoot. I have not done a vlog in a while. So, bear with me. here we go.
Haven't done a vlog with a microphone, so this is something different. Hope you guys enjoy it. I don't know, just kind of getting used to it. All right.